Careful. The underbrush can be a bit noisy this time of year. Sounds like Gerlinda could use a hand. Oh, sorry. I just got a message from one of the local residents, Gerlinda Jaeger. I'll check in with her later to see what she needs help with. Quite a view, isn't it? From here, you can see a lot of great hunting opportunities in the nearby area. Rattenfeld is a favorite region for a lot of hunters. The fallow deer is such a classic animal to hunt. But we also get a lot of history buffs here. To the south lies the Hirschdorf Hügelgrab, a grave mound dating back to the Bronze Age. Be sure to stop by one of the outposts. They're essentially base camps. getting some exercise, aren't we? Just remember to take a breather before shooting anything. cozy, right? Outposts are great for stocking up or just taking a break. Hi there. I've got a bit of an unusual question. I hope you don't mind. I think I mentioned Gerlinde, right? Well, here's the thing. She's writing a book about fallow deer. Her second one, actually. She's got a small obsession for fallow deer. Anyhow, she's missing some pictures for her book and was looking for someone to help out. It's a bit specific. I remember hearing that you're quite the photographer yourself, so I thought I'd pass along her offer. She's looking for a picture of a fallow deer taken in Rattenfeld. She'll pay quite well for it, so it may be worth the effort. If you were looking to help out Gerlinde with that picture, you're in the right place. You're in Rattenfeld. Oh, you found a shed! I remember finding a big deer antler for the first time as a kid. It felt like I had dug up some real treasure. I still have it at home. Gerlinde is lovely, but here's a friendly tip. Don't ask her about fallow deer unless you mean it. She will not stop. It's beyond obsession at this point. On the other hand, there's no one better for hunting tips when it comes to fallows. Oh, and her venison stew is out of this world. Makes me hungry just thinking about it. If you want a neat challenge to pass the time when not hunting, many of the animals are shedding their antlers this time of year. They're still tricky to find, of course, but I guess that's why people like to collect them.